Hello students, in this video of ours, we are going to learn about how microbes are helping us in sewage treatment and biogas production. The application of microbes in sewage treatment. What is sewage? Sewage is the wastewater which is containing human excreta. Now, there is production of millions of gallons of wastewater globally. Now, if this wastewater is thrown or is disposed of in the water reservoirs, natural water reservoirs of the nature, then the water is going to be contaminated because this sewage contains lot many disease germs. The sewage contains many pathogens. So we cannot just release the sewage from the pipes into the water bodies because this is going to pollute the water bodies, and that contaminated water is going to spread many kinds of diseases among the human beings. So it is a major problem that how to treat this sewage which is being produced in such a large quantity in human colonies. But here also the microbes are there to help us, and till today no other human man-made thing is equally competent to treat this sewage as microbes are. So everywhere you will find the sewage treatment plants. And we are taking the help of these microbes. They are our friends. We are taking their help to clean off the sewage, and they are helping us in treatment of sewage. And then this after treatment, this sewage water, when it is getting converted into good water, then it can be released into the water reservoirs. So in this, we are going to see that how this sewage is treated by microbes. Now, sewage basically consists of human excreta. It may contain many microbes which may be pathogenic also, because it is a dirty water and it contains lot of pathogens. Now, sewage disposal is a huge problem. It cannot be directly disposed into rivers and streams. Hence, it has to be treated first in sewage treatment plants. So there are plants in different locations of everywhere in the globe. And these sewage treatment plants, which are called STPs, they are using microbes to treat the sewage. Now, these heterotrophic microbes present heterotrophic sewage itself aid in its treatment. So we do not require any other thing. The microbes which are present in the sewage only, they are themselves treating the sewage. Now, this treatment of sewage is done in two ways. Two stages are there: primary treatment and secondary treatment. Now, first of all, what happens in primary treatment, this involves physical removal of particles. Basically, two processes are done here: filtration and sedimentation. Filtration is that you have to take out the floating debris and whatever waste is produced, which is insoluble, can be taken out. Then sedimentation is the heavier particle will settle down. So that is called sedimentation. So what happens first of all in primary treatment? Initially, the sequential filtration is used to remove floating debris. Floating debris means when this wastewater is there, there are debris which are floating in it. So you have to filter it, and that is called sequential filtration. By sequential filtration, you have to remove those debris, and then grit. What is grit? Grit is soil and small pebbles. Small pebbles and the soil. Because they are the heavier things in the water, so they are removed by the sedimentation. The sediment is formed, it is just allowed to settle down, and in this settling down, the grit is formed as a sediment, and this grit is consisting of soil and small pebbles. Now, solids that settle down form the sludge. Now, what will happen? Once you have allowed the wastewater to settle down, two things will be formed. One is sediment, which is settled down at the bottom, and one is supernatant solution, which is above. So, two things are formed. The one which is settled down, that is the sediment, and this sediment is called sludge. It is called sludge. And the supernatant, which is above it, is forming the effluent. So, what we have done in primary treatment, first we have taken out all the insoluble debris, the floating debris, by filtration. Number two, we will allow that wastewater to settle down, and when we are allowing it to settle down, the grit, that is the soil and the small pebbles and other insoluble things which are present in that sewage, they will remove by sedimentation. Sediment is formed, and this sediment is called sludge. And then there is a supernatant, which is above the solution, which is above the sediment, and the above solution is called supernatant. And this supernatant solution is called effluent. Now, this effluent is taken for the secondary treatment. So, what things we have removed in primary treatment? In primary treatment, we have removed the floating debris, the insoluble waste material which are present in the sewage. Then the second thing is soil and the small pebbles. After removing these three things, the supernatant, which is called the effluent, it will be taken to the another place, which is for the secondary treatment. Now, this is the secondary treatment. Now, in secondary treatment, what happens? This effluent is passed to aeration tank. What is aeration tank? As the name suggests, aeration means where air is there. So, it is a tank where air is there. It has been constantly agitated. Constantly agitated means you are constantly shaking that water so that more and more air comes in. So this aeration tank is there, and where the constant agitation is taking place and constant air is pumped into the water. Now what happens? Because of the constant inflow of the air, there will be vigorous growth of bacteria. The bacteria are already there in the water. They will start growing in the presence of air. So vigorous growth of bacteria will be there. And then flock formation will be there. What is flock? Flock is bacteria with fungus. So bacteria and fungus, they will form a mesh-like structures, which are called flock. Now what will happen? The whatever waste material is present. Now this waste material is what? Waste material is organic matter. The human excreta and the other waste material which are present in the sewage are what? They are organic matter. Now, what will happen? The bacteria will start decomposing those organic matter. Now, when the bacteria is using that organic matter, is consuming that organic matter, what will happen? There will be decrease in the biochemical oxygen demand. What is biochemical oxygen demand? It is called BOD. Why? In any wastewater, in any sewage, there is BOD. BOD is what? It is the amount of oxygen that would be consumed if all the organic matter of 1 liter of water. In 1 liter of water, whatever organic matter is present will all get oxidized by the bacteria. So the bacteria will require oxygen for that. So that is called BOD. So as the bacteria will decompose or oxidize this organic matter, there will be decrease in the BOD. So BOD actually is a parameter to find out how polluted the water is. More the BOD, more polluted is the water and less the BOD, less polluted. Why? Because if the biochemical oxygen demand is more, the more amount of oxygen is required, that means the organic matter is more. And if more organic matter is there, that means it is more polluted. So what happens? Slowly and slowly, when this bacteria is consuming the oxygen to decompose this organic matter, to oxidize this organic matter, the slowly and slowly there will be decrease in the BOD. And what will happen? The organic matter will also slowly and slowly decreases. So when the organic matter will decrease, BOD will decrease. BOD will decrease, pollution will decrease. So what happens? This is a measure to find out that how much organic matter is present in the water. So in tanks and all, this is found by the BOD. So BOD is a parameter to find out whether the wastewater or the sewage water is more polluted, or now it is being treated, or it is yet the treatment is required. So all these things can be find out, okay, we can find out by measuring the BOD. Because if BOD is large, that means there is still a large amount of organic matter present in the water. So that means the water is still very polluted. If the BOD has decreased, that means the organic matter which is present in the water is decreased and the pollution is decreased. So now the waste material, the harmful material, the pollution in the water has decreased. So this is how they will find out. Now what is a flock? Flock we have discussed here also. Vigorous growth of bacteria will form the flock. Flock is what? Flock is bacteria and fungal filaments. So some fungus will also come and joins the bacteria, and both they both together form a mesh like structure. So this mesh like structure is called flock. Now when BOD and pollution is reduced, then the effluent is passed into a settling tank. Here flocks settle down and it is known as activated sludge. Now what will happen in the wastewater? In secondary treatment, what we have done is we have put the effluent into the aeration tank. In aeration tank there is agitation, and because of the agitation there is inflow of air, and then because of the inflow of air there is growth of bacteria, and this growth of bacteria will start consuming the organic matter, will start oxidizing the organic matter present in the water, and slowly it will consume all the organic matter present in the water. So the BOD will decrease and the pollution of the water will decrease. Now the pollution is reduced of the sewage water. Now this effluent, now again the whatever is present out up is effluent. Now we will send this into another tank which is called settling tank. Here what will happen? The flock is what? Now we don't require many bacteria and many fungal filaments, because now the BOD has been decreased and the pollution in our water is decreased. So what we will do is we will put the take the effluent into a settling tank, and here the flock will settle down, and this flock is called activated sludge. This flock is called activated sludge. Why it is called activated? Because it is consisting of bacteria and fungal filaments which are living. So it is active. That's why it is called activated sludge. Now what will happen to this activated sludge? Small part pumped back to aeration tank. Small part. Some part of this sludge will be put back to the aeration tank. Again, for oxidation of the organic matter, remaining organic matter. So the small part pumped back to aeration tank where it acts as flock for the next cycle. And the remaining part is pumped into the anaerobic sludge digesters. Now, these anaerobic sludge digesters are there to produce the biogas from them. What is anaerobic? Anaerobic is the in the absence of oxygen. So this in anaerobic sludge digesters, the anaerobic bacteria, they act on the activated sludge and they produce biogas. What is biogas? Biogas is a mixture of methane, CH4, carbon dioxide, CO2, hydrogen sulfide, H2S. So the mixture of these gases is called biogas. So in anaerobic sludge digesters, this anaerobic bacteria will act on the activated sludge to produce biogas. Now the effluent from secondary treatment plant. Now the secondary treatment is complete. When the BOD is reduced, we have checked that now the BOD is reduced. The BOD is very, very less. So that means the pollution is no more there. So now after this secondary treatment, the effluent from the secondary treatment plant is released into the water bodies. So we can use that water again and it is released into the water bodies. Now see how helpful these microorganisms are to us. This microbial technology for sewage treatment is so effective that no human technology has been able to beat it till date. Till date, after so much of advancements of techniques and everything, we are not yet able to devise or to discover or to produce any technology which will be affecting or which will be helping us in the sewage treatment more than this microbial technology. So microbial technology is still the best technology for treatment of sewage. So see how friendly they are to us, how essential they are to us. When we talk about biodiversity, when we talk about microorganisms, we don't understand their role. But now after going through all these things, you will understand that how important this microbial world to us. They are not seen by our naked eyes, but they are doing so much for us that we cannot survive. Our survival is in doubt without them. So still till date, this microbial technology is the effective technology which is used all over the globe, not only in India, in foreign countries also for sewage treatment. Microbial technology is used. Now another thing is microbes, as we saw here, that this activated sludge is acted by the anaerobic bacteria and they produce biogas. Now this biogas is a renewable source of energy. We can use it. We can use it for lighting our lamps. We can use it as domestic fuel. Many villages, they have biogas plants. And these biogas plants are being used, are operational for production of energy. So microbes produce many gases during their metabolism. And we have seen that carbon dioxide is produced, methane is produced, hydrogen sulfide is produced, hydrogen is produced. So they all together are called biogas. The type of gas produced depends upon the substrate they grow on and the type of microbe. Which substrate is there and which kind of microorganism is acting on that substrate, that is deciding which gas is being produced. Now anaerobic bacteria, they usually produce methane along with carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and nitrogen. Such bacteria are called methanogens. The bacteria which are helping in production of methane, because methane is the main gas of biogas. So they are called methanogens. And the example, one example of that bacteria is methanobacterium. So methanobacterium are the bacteria which are methanogens, which are helping in production of methane. Now methanogens are commonly found in anaerobic sludge. Now, what is anaerobic? And when we, the sludge which we got in the sewage treatment, they are found in them. And in the rumen of cattle, the cattle, the cows, the buffaloes, they in their rumen, in their gut also, we will find these methanogens, because their excreta is called gobar. That's why their excreta is called gobar, because they are rich in the methanogens. So that's why biogas is also called gobar gas. In villages, you will find the name gobar gas. So, and the excreta is called gobar. So in the rumen of cattle, these bacteria help in the cellulose digestion, because they are mainly feeding on cellulose, the green leafy material, and this cellulose is digested by these bacteria, methanogens, and they are converting the cellulose into the biogas. Now, these excreta of cattle, that is gobar, are rich in methanogens, and biogas is called gobar gas. So, in villages, if you find the biogas plants, then in biogas plants, what is fed in a biogas plant to produce the biogas is the gobar, because gobar is available in all, everywhere you will find these cattle in the in every house of the village you will find cattle, and in every house of the village you will find gobar. So this gobar can be used in this biogas plant to produce biogas. Now what is the biogas? What are the components of it? You will find one compartment where you can feed the dung and the water. This is also called slurry. Then there is a digester, and this is sludge. So with sludge and this, this digester is having the bacteria which are acting on the slurry. And when they act on slurry, they produce the biogas. So this CH4, CO2, methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, all these gases are produced in this gas holder. So this is called gas holder. And from this gas holder, there is an outlet of gas from here. So there is a pipe from where the gas comes out. So this is biogas plant. You will find biogas plant operational in many villages. If there is any biogas plant nearby your house or your village, you must go and visit this place. So this is how they are producing it. Now what all things are there? The tank is there where slurry of dung is fed. Now this is a tank where the slurry is what? Dung with water is fed, and it is 10 to 15 feet deep tank. Then there is a floating cover which is placed on the slurry. It rises as the gas is produced, because as the gas is produced, the cover which is floating will rise. And then there is the outlet from where the pipe is connected, and it is the gas is being sent out. And this pipe is supplying the biogas to nearby houses. Now, from this outlet, you can connect it with the pipe, and this pipe can take this gas to the wherever it is required. It can be used for street lights. It can be used for domestic fuels. So wherever it is required, it can be sent. It can be sent to the nearby houses. And this outlet for spent slurry. Now this spent slurry, which has been used, is acting as a good, very good fertilizer, because it is increasing. It will increase the nutrient value of the soil, and it will act as a fertilizer. So from biogas plant, the waste, which is the spent slurry, this also can be sprayed, or this also can be thrown into the farmlands, and it acts as a very good fertilizer, very good manure to increase the nutritive value of the soil. Now biogas plants is usually set up in rural areas. Why? Because cow dung is available in an abundance there, because in cities it is difficult to find cow dung. And biogas is used for cooking and lighting in many areas. You can Google search, and there are many areas these days where the street lights are all lighting with biogas only. No other electricity is used, no other energy is used, and it is used for cooking. So wherever the biogas plant is there, the village is using that biogas for domestic, as domestic fuel for cooking. Then biogas technology in India is due to the efforts of IARI, that is Indian Agricultural Research Institute, and Khadi and Village Industries Commission. These are the two institutes which have done a lot of efforts for this biogas to improve and to produce this biogas technology. So this is all about the microbes' role in sewage treatment and biogas production of biogas.